In this video, I'm going to show you how to rank on Google on the first page, even if your site is new. If you type in Bora Bora Sharks into Google right now and click Google search, you will see that my website travelcroc.com is the number one result on Google. And this website has a very weak domain without backlinks, and I'm still managing to rank on page one. I'm going to show you exactly how I did it and how you can do the same for your content as well. If we analyze this search term in Ahrefs Bora Bora Sharks, you will see that my website is the featured snippet Travel Croc and my domain rank is just 2. You can see that over here. And with this weak domain, I'm managing to outrank some insanely strong websites such as TripAdvisor with a domain rank of 93, Smarter Travel with domain rank of 80. Another TripAdvisor, the New Zealand version of it, with domain rank 85, and other websites such as stuff.co.nz with domain rank 88. I'm beating all of these websites and I'm ranking at the number one position, and I'm going to show you exactly how. Hey everyone, my name is Greg Kononenko. On this channel, I publish regular videos where I show you how to get free traffic and how to rank your site on page one of Google. Click subscribe just below this video to stay up to date. So, can your site really outrank big websites, established websites with a lot of money and a lot of authority? This is one of the most common questions that I get asked on this channel, so I wanted to record this video to show you that it's absolutely possible for you to rank your site on page one of Google. So I've already given you one example where my website Travel Croc outranks a ton of other very powerful websites such as TripAdvisor. Let's look at another example, and that's a keyword Bora Bora Facts. I've actually just started typing it in here so you can see that it's a really frequently searched term that's recognized by Google, Bora Bora Facts. So if I click that, you can see that my website is ranking at the number 3 position for this keyword Bora Bora Facts, and I actually outrank even Wikipedia for this keyword. Do you guys also want to outrank Wikipedia for some of your target searches? If you think this is pretty cool and you'd like to do that, then drop me a comment below and let me know that you'd like to do that as well. The first thing that you need to do if you want to rank on Google first page is to make sure that you choose the keywords with the right difficulty. Let's use the travel niche as an example for this video. One of the ways to find great keywords for a blog in the travel niche is to type in names of different countries into Ahrefs. And after you bring up the results inside Keyword Explorer for that country, choose the option on the left having same terms. That's going to bring up all of the keywords in the Ahrefs database that have got the word Vanuatu in them. You can see we've got 16,208 keywords, and a lot of them have got pretty high keyword difficulty. If your website is brand new or still in the early stages, then you will want to make sure that you choose a maximum keyword difficulty and apply a filter with a maximum value of 5, and then click apply to see what kind of results it filters. Now our keywords have been cut down to 371. However, all of the keywords that we've got here are extremely easy to rank for, and many of them are excellent candidates for your blog. This is an example for the travel niche. However, you can absolutely apply the same technique to any other niche, whichever niche your blog is in. After that, you will need to apply your judgment to see which keywords hold high value for you or low value for you. For example, Survivor Vanuatu probably is not going to be suitable for a travel blog. Time in Vanuatu might not be suitable for a travel blog. However, keywords such as Champagne Beach Vanuatu, Vanuatu Volcano, especially fishing in Vanuatu, might actually be excellent topics for articles for a travel blog. Step number 2 that I normally do in my keyword research process when I want to rank on page 1 of Google is to look for weak domains in the top 10 domains on the first page of results. The way to do this would be if we wanted to consider further and analyze this keyword Champagne Beach Vanuatu, would be to open this SERP option so that we get this drop down of results and then look in detail on page 1 of search engine result pages. These are all of the results that are currently in Google coming up on page 1, and what I'm looking for is this value AR, which stands for Ahrefs rank, and ideally we want to see as many websites here with high values of AR as possible. So an AR rank of, for example, 17 tells us that this is a very strong website and probably might be a tiny bit hard for us to compete with. So Wikipedia, you can see, has got AR of 17. But what we want to see is websites like this Sento.travel that has got an AR rank of 8,600,000 or 8.6 million, which means that in the overall league ladder of websites on the internet, it's towards the bottom. So the strongest website is number one and the weakest is at the very bottom. Ideally, I like to see at least two or three websites that have a rank of over 1 million, because that then tells me that there are other weak websites that are managing to rank on page one. So my website will also have hope of ranking. So for this particular keyword, Champagne Beach Vanuatu, we can see that there are three weak websites that are managing to rank on page one. So this is a massive tick and a really good sign. The next thing that I do is I check the length of content of these competing pages. This is a manual job, but it does not take too long. So you can open each of these in a new tab and then calculate the number of words on this page. So you can select all of the text like this and either copy and paste it into Microsoft Word, which will give you the word count, or you can use an extension such as Word Counter. And this one has told me that there are 104 words on here. So then I will copy and paste this URL into a brand new notepad document and I'll put down 104. And I will repeat this with each of the results. So then I will open up my favorite escapes and do the same thing. This article on myfavoriteescapes.com is a little bit longer, so when I count these words, it's got 1,576. I'll add that into the notepad. And in just a couple of minutes, you can end up with a list that's looking like this. So this is telling us that most of the pages that are currently ranking on page one actually have very short content. So the longest one is My Favorite Escapes. They've got 1,576 words. However, all other articles are extremely short. And also, when we look at the Wikipedia that's ranking number one, they basically have got no information on Champagne Beach and Vanuatu. They've only just got 71 words. So this means that nobody has actually written a proper guide on Champagne Beach and Vanuatu so far. And this keyword is getting 1,100 searches per month, which is pretty crazy. No one's taken advantage of this opportunity yet. Now, why is this important? Here is why. Google loves long-form content. Google loves content that is in-depth, authoritative content. That is the exact reason why this super weak website, myfavoriteescapes.com, they've written a decent guide on Champagne Beach Vanuatu, and look at the websites that they are outranking. They are outranking Vanuatu Travel, which is a very strong website, domain rank 57. They are outranking Daily Post, they are outranking Expedia.com, and they are outranking Flight Network. Only because if we look at the word count, we can see that they're the only website that has actually written a proper long form content. So rankings on page one of Google, they don't depend on the AR, Ahrefs rank, or on DR, domain rank of a website. That is a part of the consideration. However, one of the main things that Google wants is they want to show super high quality, in-depth content. And that is the exact reason why myfavoriteescapes.com are there at position number five, outranking all of these massive websites. That is also the reason why I outrank all other websites for such keyword terms as Bora Bora Facts, where I'm outranking Wikipedia, I'm outranking Travel Team and various other sites, because I have written a proper long form article with a lot of media and it's an in-depth content. Whereas the Wikipedia article, which by the way, I'm outranking, I'm ranked above Wikipedia for Bora Bora Facts. They actually have very little content. If you look at it, there is not a lot of information here. My article is longer, it's more in depth, and this is why Google preferred to show my content instead of Wikipedia's content. So the takeaway here for you is to make sure that you don't just focus on domain rank, but look at the length of the underlying content. The next thing that you'll want to look at if you want to rank on the first page of Google is the intent of the search. Let's say you are analyzing the keyword combination buy jeans and you've brought up all of the terms that include that combination, and you might come across something like where to buy bell bottom jeans. By the way, I have no idea what the bell bottom jeans are, but anyway, it might seem like a good keyword because it's got a decent search volume. It also seems to have a buyer intent, which you might think is a good thing. and it's got a keyword difficulty of just 4. And when we look at the first page of results for this keyword, we can see that every single result that comes up is actually a shop or a store where people can actually buy those jeans, those bell-bottom jeans. There are no blogs on page 1 at all, and that is because Google knows that the person who is entering that into Google, they actually want to buy jeans. They're not looking for blog or information on bell-bottom jeans. They're not looking for references for where they can go and buy them. They're actually looking for a store that sells them. And so if you write a blog post with where to buy bell-bottom jeans and put links to all the different places, you're never going to rank on page 1 simply because there are no other blogs that are ranking there. And that is a sign that Google does not want blogs. They want to show shops on page 1. So pay attention to that. And make sure that when you're analyzing your keyword, you're having a situation similar to what you can see here, where some of the results are actually blogs, such as this myfavoriteescapes.com, which is a blog with information about the topic of the search. If there are already 1, 2, or 3 blogs on page 1 that have got information type similar to what you're going to write your article about, that is a good sign. That's what you want. That means that you will have a very good chance of getting there onto page 1 as well. The last step of what it takes to rank on Google first page is to make sure that your content is the best content out of all of the pages that you can see on page 1 so far. That usually means at least 2,000 words. That usually means that you need to insert some high quality images. On a lot of my posts, I also embed YouTube videos, Google likes, rich media content. So make sure that you insert several attractive images. Also, you can embed other people's videos from YouTube. Just grab the embed code from YouTube and insert them into your blog post. That will allow people to watch those YouTube videos while they're staying on your blog. That will in turn increase user engagement metrics, the time that the user spends on the page, and Google tracks all that, and they will know that people stay on your page for a long time, they enjoy your content, and therefore you will increase your chances to go up the Google rankings. This is what I do personally to rank on Google first page, even with my very weak, low authority websites. If you enjoyed this video and want to get similar videos in the future, make sure to hit that subscribe button just below this video, tick the bell notification icon as well, and this way you'll get notified whenever I upload my next video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.